come to Cabo.
Yay!
5 minutes till we reach Cabo. We're on the highway right now and it's pure desert.
Family, and we are in Cabo, Mexico.
Usually when we go to a hotel, we do a thing called the human bed set, which basically means that the kids or myself, usually me, will take a run up and spread our legs and arms out and just kind of test the bed mattress and see if it's quite springy and quite comfortable for landing. So Emiliana is now going to demonstrate that. Emiliana, over to you, girl.
Okay.
All right, count yourself in, yeah?
What's the verdict?
So it's a little bit hard, but it's kind of soft and smooth. And yeah.
Pillow's comfy?
Yeah. Oh yeah, it's really comfy.
So we all know Cabo San Lucas, proper party town, spring breakers everywhere, having fun. And if that's where you want to be, it's all about Medano Beach. It's clearly where Ben wanted to be. Medano Beach, you've got the beach clubs, you've got the people, it's just absolutely ramajama.
Crazy.
As a family though, we did prefer to be a little bit more on the quieter side. So we headed over to the right side, which you can walk to from the marina, and literally it's the complete opposite, wasn't it? White sands and the blue water.
Quiet, tranquil.
The water is a bit rough, so watch out with your babies because the tide comes in and then literally it can pull them back out again.
But
we're glad we found a little bit of peace and quiet, and it was totally a relaxing place to be on Medano Beach.
So we're in Cabo, Mexico at this kind of hole in the wall taco place called Tacos Gus. And whenever you order a taco or anything, the meat taco, you get all this lovely stuff here, which is great. All the salads and the coriander and onions and lime. But you also get all these sauces with no signs, so you don't know what's mild, what's too hot, what's medium. So basically, you just got to test them. Obviously, that's guacamole, which we love. But everything else, I'm not sure, so let's try it out. That's definitely habanero. That's red habanero. Don't try it, Emiliana. No, don't try it. It's too hot. Okay, let's try the green one.
I tried it.
Yup, that's the green habanero, but not as hot as the red. It's a little bit chilly, yeah. Okay, let's try. I think this is just salsa, but let's go. That's just tomato salsa. A little bit of a kick, not too bad. We know guacamole. This looks really, really spicy. Like, look at the seeds in that.
I'm gonna try the guacamole.
Okay. All right, let's try that.
That looks chili.
That's not actually spicy, but it's a bit earthy, not really my cup of tea. And the last one, this has got like peppers or actually no, jalapenos I think in it, and you can still see seeds as well. Let's give it a go. That's like a sweet, very mild. So I think actually it looks like it's mild all the way through to spicy. I didn't know that. Now you do when you come. comes to Tacos Gus. Spicy, not so spicy. All in all, great place. Make sure you check out this hole in the wall if you do come to Cabo.
Now, we love food, like I'm sure you guys do too as well. So coming into Mexico, there's lots of different types of foods to try, lots of different names. So we're going to give you a quick rundown on what the food options are here in Mexico.
Of course, you have tacos, and from where we're from, which is the UK, tacos are a hard shell. But in Mexico, it's the complete opposite. It's a round, soft tortilla, usually made from corn, and it's literally topped with rice, beans, meat, and basically you get a nice whole bunch of salad which you can add on, and it's yummy in all the different sauces.
So, the tostada. So the tostada is a hard shell. It's topped with anything inside, from beans to marinated seafood to meat and salad.
Quesadilla. We all know the quesadilla is basically a round, soft tortilla with cheese folded in half, and then you can pretty much have anything else that you want in it, which is good.
Chilaquiles.
You know, he lets me order that one for him, but yeah.
So, so the chilaquiles is a deep fried tortilla with spicy sauce.
Then we have the huaraches, which is basically a thicker tortilla, a kind of oval shape, and it's covered in meat, beans, and salad, or anything else that you prefer.
Hey, everyone.
We're gonna be going on the pirate ship, but not from this book. The pirate ship's right there. It is going to be yellow, black, and brown with some
orange. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Are you finished?
Are you finished?
Okay,
we're going to be having some chicken strippers.
Oh, chicken strippers, cool.
And we have meat wraps and chicken wraps.
Oh, sounds amazing. Everyone comes to Cabo and goes to see the Arco, which is a naturally formed rock. You can pay a local fisherman $10 to go down there to see it, and you can take pictures and come back. But we thought we'd try and do something a bit different, so we took out the local pirate ship, which is called the Cabo Legend.
And it was a legend.
Which was great fun. We got the kids on board, they were singing and dancing and playing games, and it was good fun.
We got to see the arch and snorkeling
as well, which was always, you know, a big, big plus. And so we would definitely recommend the Cabo Legend pirate ship as well.
Definitely great for kids, even better for adults, with all-inclusive food and drink.
Yeah. And if you do it, look out for a guy called Gabriel, because he was great.
The captain.
Mummy's got the moves. Emiliana, go dance with Mummy. Why? There you go. Oh, wow.
Woo-hoo! On the route to the Philippines, they have to make a stop right here for fresh water for food. Once they do that, English pirates will load the canyons and attack the Spanish galleon. They cover the treasure. San Lucas is a true pirate land. Yes. fotógrafo profesional.
Bye.
Cabo San Lucas.
Su nombre y de dónde nos visita. Your name and where you're from.
Xylene from London.
Xylene desde Londres. Ahoy, matey! You watch a lot of movies. Usted ve mucha tele, amigo. Felicidades. Congratulations. You get a tequila bottle sponsored by Patron and $100 gift certificate for Diamonds International. Yes! Everybody! Everybody, clap your hands for the winners, our pirates! It was great having the Flip Flop family right here in the Cabo Legend. Pirates, from London directly to the Cabo Legend. Don't forget to see us again. We are Cabo Legend with the Flip Flop family right here, right now!
Sweet tooth that I have and that Emiliana definitely has, we were after churros. It wasn't as easy to find as we thought. We literally had to go and hunt down the churros truck, but when we found it, it was totally worth it.
Cinnamon and sugar churros. So you can get single giant churros, or you can get a pack of smaller ones. What do you want? What do you fancy?
I want bigger ones.
One big one?
Yeah.
Okay, then just get a big one. Yeah. Oh, they squeeze it into the middle. Hola.
And I just like come by here too.
Will you now? Gracias. Yeah? Good? Look at that. Oh. Cheers. Churros, cheers. La Casita. It's really cute. And they do, it's a bit random because they have a proper wood-fired pizzas, but they also have really good sushi and they do Mexican too. So it's a bit of a random menu, but we totally recommend it if you do come to Cabo because the waiter Leo is really nice and the food is awesome.
But on the personal level, it's perfect for us. I love pizza and my wife loves sushi.
That is their tempura roll. It's basically shrimp, avocado, cucumber, and the whole roll is tempura'd.
So after 4 nights in Cabo of partying, going out, no, I'm only joking. We were with the kids, so it wasn't like that at all.
Chocolate milk and...
and early bedtime. We wanted to go to a place called La Paz, which was a nice beachy area. La Paz was about a 2.5 hour drive away from Cabo, so we decided to take an hour away and stop off at a little village called Todos Santos, which was nice. It was pretty quiet, very quaint, but a nice place to be.
Todos Santos, absolutely. Got like the view of the waters on the left. Dry desert, cactus, and the rest of it on our right. Here we go, that's our hotel for the night. Hotel Maria Bonita. Our room number is number 1. And it's really cute. Once again, quite modest, but so simple and very, very cute. The kids have just walked in. Do you like it, Zaki?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you like your new house?
Right,
so we're ready for the Ewan's bed test?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Where's Daddy gonna go? Minnie, move out of the way, let Daddy have a go. Oh, and Zaki? Oh look, he's rubbing his hands, he's ready. He's ready.
It has the Hotel California, which
is rumoured to have something to do with the Eagles, but it doesn't. It has the Missionaries, which is like a big church, and it seemed like everybody was praying the day we got there, as it was Sunday, and the town was pretty dead because of that reason. But it was still a nice pit stop, known for art and surfer beaches as well, but a good pit stop on the way to La Paz. After a pleasant stop in Todos Santos, it was back in the car, more driving for Benjamin, but luckily only an hour up the road, up the Baja, towards La Paz. But it really was a complete breath of fresh air, absolutely beautiful place. And if you would like to know what we got up to in La Paz, a little sneak peek, we saw amazing sea lions and also the madness of Mexico City, then do check us out.
Don't forget, you can catch us on every social media platform. So go onto Instagram at the Flip Flop Family. Go onto Facebook. We've got a Facebook group there, the Flip Flop Family, of course. Our Twitter as well. And you can go onto our website, which is theflipflopfamily.net, for up-to-date information about what we're doing and all the goings on.
Thanks so much for supporting us and watching our YouTube channel. But for now, it's adios.